Looking to turn some old cards into new fetch lands? Check out ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We've got ferociously competitive prices on cards new and old, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you'd prefer to pick up singles, boosters, or even a battle box, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order, and soon you'll be rolling in villainous wealth.
Hey guys, Sam Pardee here, and I'm going to be playing a little red-white aggro, a deck I wrote about last week for Channel Fireball, so check out the article if you're interested in hearing some of the reasonings behind my choices, and let's get to some games. Alright, here we are for round one. We're on the draw, and I think this hand is pretty decent. Yeah, it's definitely a keep anyway. Got some early defense, an early creature, and then Storm Breath. So we're probably playing against Jeskai. Definitely gonna top Hordling Outburst here. Probably Jeskai could be. Oh, no, looks like. Maybe Heroic, maybe a control deck. We'll see. Either way, our Stormbreath Dragon should be quite good. Silk Wrap. Alright, man down. Well, Rabblemaster. I was going to just play Outburst, but getting Rabblemaster in while our opponent can't do anything about it is definitely better, because we're going to generate a token's worth of value at least, whereas, you know, at some other point, if, like, Last Breath or something is held up, then we might not get a token's worth of value. Silk Wrap Part 2. Okay. I guess I'll attack first if our opponent wants to Last Breath or something, which seems unlikely, but I don't mind giving them the opportunity. And I'm fine getting this countered by, like, Clash of Wills or whatever. Yeah, just nothing. Alright, we don't need another land. So I'm definitely not just going to jam Stormbreath here, because I'm... Unless our opponent does something, obviously. Monastery Siege. Okay. Like, basically I don't want to just run into... Choosing Dragons, what is that? Which one is that? The one that makes our spells cost more? Okay. I accept. Yeah, I don't want to just run Stormbreath into a Wrath, so I think we have enough pressure on board that a Wrath is pretty necessary anyway. So the only downside here is potentially Elspeth, but because we have two burn spells, I'm not really worried about that. I guess there's the downside of counter magic as well, but we have enough pressure that holding up counter magic is going to be difficult. Our opponent's going to have to tap some mana to kill these goblins at some point. Yeah, like, just Banishing Light is not going to cut it here. I think I'm actually just going to send a Lightning Strike upstairs. We still have Wild Slash plus Stormbreath is enough to kill Elspeth. I'm still not probably just not going to play Stormbreath on our next turn. Although I think that makes it very unlikely that our opponent has a Wrath. There's not much reason to play into Counter Magic, which they could have up right now. Obviously don't know that they have counter spells, but there's no reason not to play around it. We're still killing pretty quickly here as well. We can end of turn Stoke, which puts our opponent at 5, and then the 3 goblins plus Wild Slash finish the job. So we can win without even casting the Storm Breath, theoretically. Okay, so that's what's going on. I think this is going to work out really badly, though, because we're going to like kill a Silk Wrap, get back our Rabble Master, and just go nuts. Gonna attack for like a bajillion damage this turn. Was it any permanent they control? I thought it was just creatures. Or just them. Okay, well, whatever. Yeah, so we can just smash with everyone, and then it's lethal by itself. But if something happens, I don't even know what can happen for one mana. Nope, we win. So, sideboarding. Definitely want Revoke Existence. I think we want the long game cards. And I think we probably want to cut down on Wild Slash. And Lightning Strike, maybe. And just keep the big sized burn spells. Don't really know exactly what's going on with our opponent's deck. Like, I don't really know exactly what their game plan is. Chain actually is probably pretty bad. Maybe I'll cut those and leave in the Lightning Strikes and 2 Wild Slash. Yeah, let's give this a whirl. All right, here we are for game 2. We are on the draw, and this hand looks just fine. We have a sideboard card that we can't cast yet, but our clock is still pretty fast, especially given the way our opponent's deck is constructed. It looks like all of their interaction is sorcery speed. I'm not 100% sure that that's true, but probably means that our Rabble Masters will generate a token's worth of value at least each before getting Silk Wrapped or Banishing Lighted or whatever. Nothing much going on yet. Yeah, I'll just go ahead and Rabble. Still a turn before Wrath can happen. It doesn't have Dissolve Mana up, so it'd have to be Clash of Wills exactly to counter this. Alright, Banishing Light is going to take care of Rabels, and we'll add another one next turn. I think that's slightly better than playing Outburst next turn. Somewhat close, though. Let's see what our Scry shows us. Untap land would be great. Bottom that. I just want to land. Yeah, I guess I'll just play the Rabble Master. If we get Wrath, it's probably slightly better to have played the Outburst to have the Rabble Master left. But I think if we get Wrath, we're very likely to just kill them with Storm Breaths. I guess actually because we have Revoke anyway, it doesn't matter all that much. Citadel Siege. Sure. Choosing the tapping mode, I assume, yeah. Okay. And he has another land, so I think that probably means he does not have Wrath. I'm just going to revoke this, and we get to smash for like a billion this turn. Puts our opponent to 8, and then so even if the Rabble Master gets neutralized, we still have lethal. Alright, well, that was pretty simple. So we will be back for round 2 after this. We'll be right back.